Welcome to the EDELRID Knowledge Base. I'm Florian Hellberg, and today we have a guest, Alex Bell from ABS, and we want to discuss what a climbing harness and the Avalanche Airbag backpack have in common. What do these two pieces of equipment have in common?
So basically, these two products are not only sports equipment, these belong to your personal protection equipment. That means your climbing harness protects you from falling from the height and can save your life. And an avalanche airbag can or increases the chance of not being buried. That means the chance of staying on top in an avalanche is very high.
Okay, and the consequence that the airbag system is PPE means that they have to fulfill a type examination from an independent notified body. The most important part for the type examination is the standard. So maybe it's interesting to have a look at the standard requirements of the airbag system.
So Flo, I put on the avalanche airbag. That means I closed the hip belt, I attached the leg loop, and I closed the chest strap here. And now if I pull the activation handle, the balloons will inflate.
Okay. And here is the first standard requirement for the activation mechanism. The force to activate the airbag has to be between 50 and 150 newtons. Let's check this out. Okay, now I pull. So I reached 50 newtons. Okay, the airbag is inflated completely within 5 seconds. Now, the next important requirement is that the airbags are stable enough to stay inflated in the avalanche. This we're gonna test next. Here in our test facility, we build up the test for the strength requirement for the airbag.
So basically we have two tests of the airbags itself. Number one is a tear strength test of the fabric. And number two is the stability of the inflated airbag balloon.
We have a weight of 10 kilograms, which falls from a height of 2 meters onto the inflated airbag. And the airbag has to withstand this impact without damage. 3, 2, 1, 0. Okay, we are here at our laboratory. And we're going to test the next important requirement for the connection between the airbags and the carrying system. Therefore, we're pulling with the aluminium frame in our tensile test machine of one of our airbags against the carrying systems, which is adapted to a wooden dummy, which simulates the person. The system has to withstand a strength of 3 kN for 1 minute. Okay, so let's start the test. So we went to the basic requirements of the standard, but we tested them all in room temperatures, and normally avalanche airbag backpacks are used in snow. So what about the temperature range of airbags?
Right, Flo. So basically the avalanche airbag should work in a range of temperature. That means at minus 30 degree as well as plus 50 degree. And especially cold temperatures are tested in a freezer. At least we put it for 24 hours in a freezer, and afterwards we pull the trigger and the airbag should be inflated like in warm conditions.
Okay, this was a short overview of the most important requirements in the standard for avalanche airbag systems. It was published as 2017. So every airbag system which is sold in the European Union has to fulfill this standard. And this is the duty of the manufacturer and the notified body. The same as for every PPE equipment, it's important that not only the new item is in good shape, but that you take as a user responsibility for service and maintenance of your product.
So basically, you are responsible for your products and your equipment. So you should check regularly your carrying system and your airbag system itself. And also important to know is that because it's a PPE product, the lifetime as well as the number of inflations is limited. And how many years you can use it and how many inflations can be done with an airbag is written in the user manual from the manufacturer, which comes with an airbag.